What camera settings should you use when you take photos of the sun? In this video, I'll show you the results of an experiment I did where I took pictures of the sun through four telescope configurations, a DSLR, and a white light filter. This is to give you an idea of what you may expect when you take images of the sun yourself. You'll probably get slightly different results based on your gear, but the idea of the spectrum and how it works will remain the same. All of my photos were taken on a sunny day between 1:30 and 2:30 p.m., so the sun was pretty high in the sky. I'll briefly cover the four panels that I made, and they'll be available for your review, and you can find the links to those in the description below. Before I go any further, I want to reiterate that you should never ever look at the sun without using the proper solar filter. You could go blind, or worse. I'll first talk about my common gear. So this is all the equipment that I used that stayed the same for the entire experiment. First, we have my camera. It's a Canon T5i, and it's a crop sensor stock DSLR. It's 18 megapixels with pixel size of 4.30 microns. Second on the list, we have my SkyWatcher SolarQuest mount, which made the entire process so much easier and faster. I have a whole video on that mount if you're interested in what the mount is like. Lastly, I took all of these images using a 1000 Oaks optical solar sheet. I made this one back in 2017 for the solar eclipse then, and it fits on my 6SE. And I made this one just a few months ago for my 60mm refractor for less than $12. So I have a video of that. Check that out after you're done with this video. I took pictures of the sun with ISO ranging from 100 to ISO 800. And with exposure settings ranging from 1/100th of a second to 1/4000th of a second. So that's 17 exposures for each ISO. That's a lot of exposures, but I wanted to really catch a whole spectrum going from really bright to really dark. And we'll see just how much it fluctuates based on my configurations. Now let's talk about my two telescopes. So first I have my AT60ED refractor made by Astrotech. And I have my NexStar 6SE SCT made by Celestron. The AT60 is a native 60mm aperture with 360mm focal length, making it an F6 scope. It's fairly fast. In its second configuration, I use a 2x Barlow, which turns its effective focal length to 720mm at f12, much slower, and we'll see the differences in the panels. My 6SE is a native 6-inch or 150mm aperture with 1500mm focal length, making it an f10. The field of view on this is actually too narrow to fit the entire sun into the image. When we look at the panels, you'll see that parts of the sun is cut off, and there's nothing we can really do about it, maybe if I had a full-frame camera. In its second configuration, I use a 0.63 focal reducer, so it lets me go out a little bit and speed up my telescope to f6.3. It's closer in speed to my AT60, but its effective focal length is about 945mm. So I zoom out enough to fit the entire sun into my field of view, and it kind of becomes a sweet spot for the entire experiment. So let's take a look at the panels. So I have the first panel of solar images here taken from my AT60 Canon T5i at its native focal length of 360mm at f6. The first time my wife saw this, she said that it looked like stadium lights, and it's kind of true, especially when you look at the bottom left-hand side here. Before I go into the individual images, let me go over what the panel looks like. So this is kind of like a chessboard or basic grid setup here. So on the left-hand side, we have the ISOs ranging from 100, 200, 400, and 800. And on the top, we have the, and going horizontal, is the exposures of 1/100th of a second all the way to 1/4000th of a second on this extreme here. And if you're using an F6 telescope with a short focal length, like 360mm around there, this is what you should expect the sun to look like if you're using a white light filter with a yellow tint. If you're using a Barlow filter, I think they only give white light. But anyways, if we look at the two extremes here, obviously ISO 800 at 1/100th of a second is too bright for you to use. So if you want to do some kind of like an HDR shot with the outside glowing, this could be something that you can take one and then take another exposure where you can actually see the surface of the sun. So if I were to use this, you can review this on your own. If I were to use this, I would first like create like an imaginary diagonal here, like get rid of all of these and not worry about any of these settings, and probably get rid of this small corner here and stick to something like around here. So if you have a similar telescope, what settings that could work for you is if you want a more orangey sun, you could go with ISO 100 and 1/1250th of a second exposure, or if you want a more yellowy sun, same exposure but at ISO 200. For the next one we're looking at is the same telescope, my AT60ED, but this time it has a 2x Barlow, which brings its effective focal length to 720 millimeters at f12. You can see that it is much darker than the f6 configuration with no Barlow. You can also see that the size of the sun is much larger compared to what we saw with the AT60 without the Barlow, and the sizes are pretty representative of what you'll see when you take the images with and without a Barlow. So it does take up more of the field of view. Of course, my sensor is rectangular, not square, so you'd see more black on the sides, but it goes deep enough to get a bigger sun, but not too deep where it gets cut off, like we'll see with my 6SE next. But because it's much slower at f12, you can see that the same images we see here, they look like almost nothing. It's just, so 1/4000th of a second just does not work. On the other hand, on the other extreme, 1/100th of a second at ISO 800, you can see some sunspots, but they're still pretty bright. So again, talking about the imaginary diagonal, this one would be a lot more extreme. So I think I would start off like here and just cut off all of these and not even consider those settings for an F12 720 millimeter small telescope, especially with a Barlow. If I were to use this configuration, I would probably stick to somewhere around these images here. So if I zoom in here, so this is ISO 400 at 1/160th of a second. So I think like these two, probably this one looks pretty good at 1/200th of a second, ISO 400. Sun looks pretty good. We can see some sunspots. And next we have my NexStar 6SE SCT, which is a native F10 at 1500 millimeter focal length. So this is where you wouldn't want to use either of the two extremes. So 1/4000th of a second, although you zoom in, you can kind of, I don't know if you can see it on the video, but you can kind of see some of the sunspot. They look like little black dots. You can see it better here, probably here. So this kind of looks like that over there. You don't want to use that. And you probably don't want to use the other extreme either. Although here at F10, 1500 millimeters, you can kind of see some sunspots, but obviously this is too bright. So again, imaginary line. Probably cut off like this much, wouldn't want to use any of those, and you wouldn't want to use any of this here. So you'd want to stick to something like in the center here. And if I were to use this configuration, I'll zoom in and you'll notice, as I mentioned before, that the sun gets cut off on the top and the bottom. Probably would have been better if I had a full frame camera, but I'll zoom in here and I think like one of these two is probably really good. When I did this in 2017, I believe my settings were ISO 400 at 1/400th of a second. So this is what I used. But if I were to do it again, I would probably use something similar and stick with this. And you can see that the sunspots are much sharper. If I used an Astrocam with smaller pixels, it probably would even look better. And last but not least, this is the NexStar 6SE with the same camera, but with the 0.63 reducer. What this does is it kind of lets me zoom out a little bit and see more of my field of view, but it changes the focal length to an effective focal length of 945 millimeters. So it's you do 1500 times 0.63 to get that value. And it changes the F ratio of the telescope to F6.3. So in terms of speed, it's similar to my AT60, but it's still a little bit slower, but much better because the focal length is 945 millimeters versus 360 millimeters. So if you start zooming in, you can see a lot more details, better details, sharper details on the sun compared to the AT60. And the extremes also look a little bit better with this. So here you can make out more of the sunspots here in the dark, but again, we wouldn't want to use those. And the extremes here on the left-hand side, on the bottom left-hand side, becomes too bright now. So ISO 800 at 1/100th of a second. So you wouldn't want to use those either. So the imaginary line here would be about here and then again here. And I think the sweet spot is somewhere in the middle here. If I were to use this configuration, I probably will as one of my setups because it fits the sun perfectly. It's gets me enough focal length to get to the sun and see pretty nice details with my DSLR. If I were to use my 523 MC Pro, it probably would look even better. And I would probably use ISO 400, probably this one at 1/640th of a second. So if you look at this, you can see the sunspots look pretty nice. They're kind of sharp. So this is what it looks like. This is the final panel of testing that I did. And it was done with the NexStar 6SE 0.63 reducer, Canon T5i, and its effective focal length of 945 millimeters at f6.3. As mentioned earlier, if you're shooting through a thin layer of clouds or smoke, your images will look a little bit different, probably a little bit darker, so it'll be like a little dark shift or blue shift, if you will, on the spectrum. But I hope this video was helpful in showing you how your telescope, your camera using a Barlow or a reducer can affect how imaging the sun will look for you. I used a DSLR in this video, but this should be the same for any camera where you can manipulate the ISO and the exposure settings. I'm hoping for clear skies next week so that I can live stream the partial eclipse from here. And I'll be using both a white light filter and my hydrogen alpha telescope. I have other videos covering my Lunt hydrogen alpha telescope, so check those out when you get a chance. And if you take pictures of the sun, again, whether it's during an eclipse or not, please feel free to share them with me. I would love to see them. Good luck to all of us next week. Clear skies.